quickest on with my next question. And, you know, the idea of collaboratively writing a story, it's really never been done before out there on a level to this degree. So I was just curious what you thought about this concept and this new way of storytelling.
Actually, I'm not necessarily a big fan of group or collaborative storytelling because you might like start squabbling about particular like how the character is developing or how the story is developing.
まあ、2人でやっても絶対意見が一致するってことはまずないんです。片方が殺すという殺すなという殺せ殺すな殺せ殺すな。そういうことにもなりますから、やはり物語を作るのは1人がいいですね。1人1人だと自由にできますから。I mean,
honestly, even if you had like two people working on a story together, you can start arguing like, I want to kill this character. No, no, you can't kill this character. No, kill the character. No, not kill the character. So, I mean, I feel like, you know, single or solo storytelling is the best because you can really do what you want to do.
それともう一つ、ユーザー同士で物語を作ったり、キャラクターを作ったりすると、権利関係が難しくなりますね。 お金の配分をどうするかという、ことになって入ってきた原稿料とか印税をどうするかという問題で結局は揉めるんですよ。だから本には。
And actually, in a practical sense too, you have to, when you do like a, especially such a multi-user collaboration, you have to start worrying about who has the legal rights to the story, and especially if it's something that you're selling, then once you start getting income from it, how you're going to split the money. So yeah, doing it on your own is much better.
So I'm going to turn it over to Mario on next one. So creating a concept and then turning it over to others creatively can be a difficult process. But in your career, have you ever experienced anything similar to this?
I never really worked in a format like this before, especially not in this caliber. But usually how a project happens is that usually the producer, like me, think of something, a theme that they want to make into an actual animation. And then after that, we have someone else develop from that. So I really think to make an interesting project is depends on the skills of the writer.
Koike Sensei also was mentioning, actually, as Mayo-san was being asked the question, that there is a difference. This is the main, a big difference between manga production or creation and anime creation, and thus that's why you're getting the two different answers as well. Koike Sensei, of course, is speaking from manga perspective.
Now, Hiromoto-san, I want to come to back to the other characters that you created. The Buddhist maiden with her seven forms. What was the origin of that design?
Yeah, 申し訳ないですけど、大体漫画、俺漫画家なんですけど、漫画描いてると、大体オチを考えて話作るのが多いんですね、基本的には。で、 今回はオチを決め、オチがわからないゆえでキャラクターを描いているので、すごい作りにくくて、描きにくいというか。でも、まあ、20年考えてますけど、なんだろう、なんだろう、キャラクターに入れることを、楽しんでもらうキャラクターを作るのは、もう習性としてあるので、だからオチを考えながら考える。だから今回の、その、オチを考えることの苦しさはちょっと初めてのことだったんで、そこはやって楽しかったことの一つではあって、あと今日本では仏像とかがすごく流行っていて、フィギュアとかで、そういうこともちょっと流行らせたいので、ニューヨークとか仏像があまりないので、この、ね、イベントを機に仏像とかが、だから仏教が流行ればいいかなと結構思ってます。
When I design this, I think of the ending first, and design make the character. But for this, I knew that there was no way for me to find out how it's going to end. So it was really difficult designing. But what inspired me to make this character is that in Japan, actually, the Buddha statue is actually a trend, and it's more of a common trend in Japan right now. So I really want, when I designed this, I really wanted the trend to sort of like flow out into the world. So I wanted everyone to really focus on the Buddha statue as well.
あと、今回その仏像なのが決まったのは、丸山さんが仏像を描いて、かわいいの。で、これ普段は人殺しとか、人だったら死にまくる漫画を描いているので、それを、マルさんはなぜ俺に可愛い女の子を描いてくれっていうオーダーがあったのがすごい不思議なんですけど、今答えてもらっていいですか？
So when there's another reason that I used the Buddha statues as a set base is because Maruyama-san told me to write cute girls. But normally I actually draw something that where people just dies constantly dying, killing each other, and so it's kind of very bloody stuff. But some reason. This man asked me why to draw cute girls. So that was a really big question for me. I still got an answer for it. So I actually like to take this opportunity to ask him why did he ask me to draw cute girls.
Why?
答えます。
Yeah.
僕は実はロリコンなんです。以上です。
So I'm actually a pedophile. So he's saying that in Japanese you call this pedophiliac lolita complex, short for lolicon. So please call him lolicon.
All right, everybody, thank you for coming. Goodbye. No. I'm gonna go in a different direction.
Sorry about this.
You know, these collaboratively written stories have evolved in really kind of fun and unique ways. But I'm sure our community would love to know, if it had been completely up to you, how would you have written the story of Red Dot?
さんもさっきおっしゃってたんですけど、僕もある程度オチから考えて、ストーリーの大枠を考えてキャラクターを作っていくので、今回も仮で自分のストーリーはいっぱい作ったんですよ。なので、はい、ストーリーはあるんですけど、またいつかお話しできれば結構話すと長くなっちゃうんで、もうすごい長い話書いちゃったんで、はい、
So as, actually Mr. Hiramoto just mentioned, I guess it's a general kind of how a Japanese manga artist creates a manga. But I too usually start from a general concept, which I then expand into an overall frame, and then storyboard it, and then come up with the characters and actual story. So this was new to have given the direction to design these characters without really knowing where the story was going. So I actually wrote my own story centering on Red Bat, but it would way too long to go into here. So maybe one day if the opportunity presents itself, maybe I could present you guys with that story. But I actually did write my own my very own Red Bat story.
Okay,
So these two are actually titled just the creators who actually develop the story first, then develop the characters. But for this project, it was specifically the goal was to make the story after they designed the character. So I know that they want to make stories, so I told them, well, I just want you guys as a character, you know, screw your story.
Well, I'd love to read it someday if you do something with it. I'd love to read it. Yeah, someday.